this CAD clip will show you a little bit about wiring and circuits and the system browser. We're using Revit 2014 in these last couple lessons in our MEP training intro series. So we'll go up to the big blue R and say open, and we'll go down to our sample files, and we're going to open up that RME Advanced sample project again. Hit OK, open. And we'll go to a lighting plan instead. And once again, I was going to do a little bit of cleanup in preparation here. So I thought, well, I might as well show you how I do the cleanup as well. It's always useful. Your system browser here is F9 on the keyboard. So you can toggle that on and off with your F9 on the keyboard. And I'm just going to squish this down a little bit if I can. Oh, I think that's as small as it'll go. So we're going to go over to our design, lighting, floor plans, and let's open up the level 2 lighting plan. So we'll open up that floor plan. And inside of there, what I want to do is use the space here to kind of demonstrate what we're going to do. And I want to clean up now. Here's an example. I want to get rid of a circuit. Okay, so if I hover over here, I can actually go in and tab to pick the network, tab again, and then click on the whole circuit, and I can say edit circuit. And if I go in and actually remove from circuit and remove everything, okay, it'll delete the circuit, which is, you know, quick enough to do. Okay, I've removed everything, and I say finish, and it's going to give me a warning down in here and say the power system circuit 13 is empty and will be deleted. That's good. Click out. Now I'm left with the wires. Okay, so what I want to do is hover over here, tab, and then pick on here, hit my filter button, take everything but the wires off, hit OK, and then hit delete. And now for the most part I've cleaned this up. If I hover and tab on this, I'm not going to get any sort of circuit. So in that case, that's one way of actually getting rid of a circuit, is delete all the objects from the circuit in the edit circuit mode, and then come out and filter and edit the wiring. Okay. Another way to do it, I'll just do an undo here. A couple of undos. Right back into my edit circuit mode. Okay. Bring those all back one at a time. Interesting how it lets me go back step by step by step. If I hover over here and tab again, I'm back to having my circuit. So at any point I can pick on these guys and it'll tell me that it's on panel LP2 on circuit 13. So if I go into my system browser here, okay, and I go to electrical and I go to power, there's a bunch of unnamed systems, but if I go down to the bottom, okay, I've got my transformer there, and then under here, then we've got our circuit breaker, okay, and then inside of here I've got this panel, and then down inside of here I believe where is it? There it is, LP2 panel, and under there are all my circuits. So there's that circuit 13, and if I mine down far enough, there's those individual lights, okay, and my lighting control sensors that are on the walls. They're not light switches, they just indicate the light. They're sensors, turn the lights on when someone enters the room. So those are the individual components. Okay, so if I wanted to, I could just right click right on here and say delete, and it's going to delete that, and you'll see it's gone from my system browser. Click over here, now the circuit's for the most part gone. Tab, click on here. I still have to get rid of the wires, take those off because I want to keep them, and then hit delete, and then we can clean it up. Okay, so it's cleaned up, and we'll notice that circuit 13 is gone out of here. So to add them back in, all you have to do is go back in here, which is kind of the other half of the example, using my control button, just like everything else. You pick the components, and then you pick the equipment and the devices. Okay, and then once you have them all selected, as long as they're all able to be created into a circuit and none of them are part of an existing circuit, you'll have your power button, and that's what creates the network. From there, you can make the wires two different wire styles or not. Okay, from there, you can go in and edit the circuit and add and remove components, or you can add select a panel. So you can select the panel now, or you can select the panel from within here. It doesn't matter. So let's go in here and say edit circuit. Once you're inside of there, there's that select from panel. Add and remove components. Very straightforward stuff. Okay. Hit finish and we're done. So now if you hover over this, tab, okay, there's the electrical circuit, but it's unnamed. Once we pick on here, we can go, click out. Let's try that again. Tab once, click. That's it. It's the first click from the network. Then we go in here and say, select the panel. Now, watch what'll happen down over here. Go back over to here to my mechanical room, hover over my LP2 panel, pick on here. In it goes. Okay. And now if I go back down here, you'll notice that. There it is. Okay. Circuit 13 is back. Okay. And while I have that selected, again, I can do it by picking it on here. Pick on it here. And I can say edit circuit. And inside of there, I want to add wiring. I keep forgetting the stage. Cancel out of there. Let's try it again. Circuit 13. So that's too high a level. Let's hit escape because there's different levels. Tab once. Pick on here. That's where I'm going to get the wiring option. Add the wires. Click out. Okay, and this has a huge home run on it. You need to pull that guy back a little bit. Pick on here. Grab this connector. I'm going to use my middle mouse button while I hold down on that connector and pan. So I'm using actually two fingers at once here. And I have to be careful because I have another node there. So I'm just going to pick there. Pull this guy down. Reconfiguring. I'm not sure if that's a bit of a bug or not. But fix that home run. Okay. Hover, tab, once, pick. Okay, hover, tab again, click, you'll get different options. Okay, and in the end, it's going to tell you the panel and the load classification and the system and all that information inside of here. So that concludes our Revit MEP introduction using mainly Revit 2013 with a little taste of Revit 2014 in the end. I hope you learned something in this series, and we have more good stuff yet to come.